Wendy here from Wendy Wise Beauty, coming to you again with another video. Today I would just like to bring you my review of the Dior Backstage Concealer. I ordered this from Dior last week, and actually I have already done a review of this. I did a full day test, I did swatches, and I lost the footage. So this video will not be as long because I have already worn this. I know what my impressions are. I can do a review. It was really sad because I don't know how I did this. I formatted the card on my camera thinking I had already moved the video over, but yeah, it's gone. Anyway, I still had the packaging. I had not thrown this away, so I thought I would just show this to you again. I ordered the concealer from Dior because it was not yet online here, and you guys know the typical Dior packaging. I got some really nice samples when I ordered this, and I like ordering from Dior just to get the samples of the exclusive perfumes. I got Vanilla Diorama, which looks like this, and then Tubacolor, which is one that looks like this. These are really nice fragrances, and these little bags are always nice to travel with or for keeping cosmetic items which can get messy in your purse or something like this. So yeah guys, this is the story. I was terribly depressed this morning when I wanted to edit this video, but this happens. Yeah, the concealer, it is called the Flashback Perfector Concealer. It is a high coverage natural glow finish, crisp proof and waterproof concealer. I got this concealer in the color 4W. There were not that many colors, so I thought 4W would be the best because my foundation shade in Dior is 4.5N. So this is what the packaging looks like. I did have a bit of problem with this packaging because you can't lay it down. And from reviewing this concealer during the last video, this is quite a bit messy because when I close the concealer back, there is always a lot of product which it runs over at the top of the concealer. The concealer has a brush and not a doe foot applicator. Actually, this is quite a nice little help for adding the foundation, but for actually blending out the foundation under the eye, you cannot rely entirely on this little brush. I have to be very careful when laying down this tube because it does run over quite easily. This is what the color looks like in 4W. I will go ahead and again do all the concealer color swatches so you can have an idea of how 4W compares to some other foundation shades on the market. This is what the shade looks like on my skin. I wanted a bit of a brightening concealer, and when applied, it does look like it should brighten the under eye area. I will go ahead and blend this out with my BK Beauty concealer brush. It blends quite easily so far. No problems with that. I will go ahead and powder with my Hermes Plein Air, translucent powder. Oh, this is such a lovely powder. You have no idea. This is the way the concealer looks when it is freshly applied. It does give a brightening effect and it does not crease at all immediately. As I stated to you guys, I did do a full wear test of this concealer, which I lost. This concealer, the experience that I made when I first applied the concealer in 4W, I got this brightening effect. It looked very nice, but at the end of the day, the concealer did darken considerably, and this brightening effect that I have at the moment, yeah, it was gone by the end of the day, or I would say not even the end of the day. After about 4 hours, I had no more brightening effect. It was the same color as the rest of my foundation. And when I tested this out earlier in the week after the 1 day test, I was wearing the Dior Natural Nude foundation and I could see no brightening effect of the concealer. Also, this concealer did crease a bit. It wasn't very bad creasing, but it did not hold up as well as my Kevin O'Quah or my Pat McGrath concealer. I had the same effect, I would say, as the Anastasia Beverly Hills concealer, where I could see some pretty long lines by the end of the day, and the concealer did creep a bit into my fine lines. Yeah, this concealer, I will use this more for spot concealing on the face, and I do know that it does oxidize somewhat, but this is not my favorite concealer. It did not blow me away. When I added it freshly on, yeah, after application 1-2 hours, it was lovely. But after the 4 hour mark, this concealer, I was not so crazy about it. It is not a bad concealer, but at the same time, it is not my favorite. I think this is a concealer you should try depending on your skin type. If you are someone like myself over 50, or if you are someone in the 40 to 50 age group, or someone with a lot of problems under the eye area, I would not recommend this concealer, because after a couple hours it does not look very nice. If you are trying to camouflage acne scars or other types of pigmentation, this would be okay. Here are some swatches of the concealer comparing the color to other concealers in my collection. This is the Dior Forever in 4W. This is Pat McGrath in number 19. This is Anastasia Beverly Hills in number 60. This is Kevin O'Quinn Supernatural in number 6. This is Black of Paris, the No Transfer Concealer. This is number 2, one I am really loving at the moment as a brightening concealer. This is NARS Radiant Creamy in the color Caramel. And finally here we have Max Factor in the color Beige. So to start again, we have Dior Backstage Concealer color 4W, and you can see it is much darker as opposed to when I applied it. Then we we have Pat McGrath in number 19, Anastasia Magic Touch number 16, Kevin O'Quinn, the Supernatural Concealer in 06, Black of Paris, the Non-Transfer Concealer in 02, NAS Radiant Creamy Concealer, this is in caramel, and the Master Touch from Max Factor in the color beige. So there you have them, all the concealers that I am using at the moment. Depending on what you use this concealer for, I think will depend on how it performs. This is probably better for the body or for spot concealing. Well, guys, this is it for this review. I mean, I had to film this twice, but no problem. I love you guys so much. I do not mind doing this. Please don't forget, I have a giveaway going on. I am giving away a brand new Byredo Flora Kalahari palette. The palette is worth $98. And I will also add in the free Tulipmania hand wash. Good luck! Good luck, guys! Ciao, bye bye, and have a good rest of your weekend. See you soon!